Power electronics are everywhere. They are in our cars, trains, planes, ships, battery management systems, industrial drives, power grids, solar plants, and more. Each of these need control systems that work reliably for years on end to make sure no accidents occur. So how can we do that? Say you want to design controls for an electric vehicle e-drive unit. You'll want to test these controls using the EDU's real electric control unit. ECUs are loaded with software code which directs how our drivetrain is going to perform. Instead of testing an actual high power system, we can have the control software operate a simulated replica. The high power system is simulated on a specially designed device, called a real-time simulator. The control system hardware, with the control software inside it, is connected to the simulator. The control system sends commands and reads information from the simulator. This methodology we call hardware in the loop, or HIL. With HIL tests, the control loop with a real high power system is replaced with a much safer, faster, lower cost, and more test-friendly simulated alternative. With HIL technologies available today, setting up such a detailed simulation environment is no longer a complicated process. This way, the controller thinks it's controlling the real system while its commands go to the HIL simulator, which models the real system and sends response signals back to the controller in real time. In a short period of time, a test report is obtained, based on which the necessary corrections are made for the smooth operation of the system. Thanks to this method, we can test for a variety of scenarios, probable and improbable, repeat the tests many times, test different power demands, communication methods, and, most importantly, undesirable events. Once all corrections are made, tests are successfully passed, the ECU is ready for safe use. With relentless HIL testing, you can be confident that your systems will perform safely, in time, and as intended.